finally go reaching our full potential as
full potential energy, man. This is
Hey, how's it going, guys? We are live on channel 69 PTV. Hey, how's it going? This is Crouch Pot Cooking, and this is my banana. No, I can't even do it. See, like other girls. See, mine has to be like shaped like a dick. I don't know. No, you know what? Never mind. Let's get to it. So today, I'm gonna be making some classic peanut butter jelly sandwich. Except wait, it's not real. It's not real. None of it's real. None of my life is real. None of it. Okay? This is bread. Okay? It's bread. None of it's real. It's not real bread. It's from D Hall. D Hall has no real food. So let's see how this goes. Okay, so we have our not real bread, and in accordance to actual classic peanut butter and jelly, we will be using real peanut butter. However, this was the cheapest peanut butter I could find. This is the cheapest. I just gotta get it open. This is the cheapest peanut butter I could find at the Moore store, guys, just to let you guys know. This is the best way to open peanut butter. I don't actually know what's happening. Okay. So a lot of misconceptions about spreading is that you put everything in the middle. You don't. You get it all over the place. But the point being is that you concentrate wherever you want everything to be in the middle and have light edges on the sides. So that when you close the sandwich, it doesn't squirt all over the place. Real cooking tips, guys. This is really how it's done as my peanut butter tries to fly away from me. So I'm trying to get it even on the first coat. I'm trying to get it nice and flat, and then I'm gonna try and bunch it up in the middle. And flatten it down. Okay. Next part. Let's just see how this is a little bit. That's heavenly. So next part are bananas. I love bananas. They're one of my favorite staple foods. A lot of people like bananas in other places, like in their mouths. I like bananas on my sandwiches. Just caught you there a little bit. So what I'm gonna do, instead of cutting my bananas straight edge like that, I'm gonna cut them at an angle. And I don't use a cutting board because my parents are Colombian and my dad freaked out when I was 5 and I was wielding a knife. And my mom was like, she's fine. Fun fact. So I've been cutting potatoes with a knife since I was 5 with no cutting board. So the reason that you cut like bread and bananas and things like that on an angle is so that you get more surface area so that you don't get that weird like gap in between, like here. It's a weird gap because I didn't overlap them. So you're trying not to get weird gaps so that the sandwich is really even, really smooth. There you go. I'm just gonna... That's where that goes. Okay. What's next? Got Nutella. I also got this from the Moore store. However, I can't smell that. However, it's gonna, let's see how that goes. Yep. That also works the way, that's not the real way to open it, but you know what? Whatever works, it works. Hold on. I feel like this works. It works for me. It's gone. So back at it. Once again, trying to get everything from the middle out to the edges. Always go from the middle out to the edges, so you don't get anything on the crust side. So you get a nice, even little edge. Oh, and a drop of peanut butter from my face just fell. And you know what? That's life. You know, sometimes peanut butter just drops from your face, and you know what? There's nothing you can do about it. And you just keep trying to make it work. always the one to put 18 coats of fucking Nutella on everything. So I'm gonna do just a literal giant ass double of this shit in the middle, everywhere. Just everywhere. And that's how that's gonna work. Because of course it is. Oh, that's nasty together. Oh jeez. Right. So after you assemble the sandwich, you have to close it. And here's the tart that I was talking about. Try and press it evenly together, and you don't have any of those overlapping, crazy, out-of-the-shell kind of pieces. And then some people cut them in half. I like to keep it full. And then we're going to sprinkle it off with a drizzle of chocolate. Chocolate syrup is the staple of my life, guys. Chocolate syrup has gotten me through multiple ex-boyfriends and multiple empty jars of fucking whatever the fuck ice cream is. So I got this honey, but guess what? I don't know how to open it. It's not openable. You can't do it. It's just not a thing that you can do. I've tried and I've tried, and you know what? It looks cute, so I'm gonna just set it right here and we're gonna pretend. Oh, what? Oh, pretending. Because fucking piece of shit. And fun fact, if you save the banana peels from the actual banana, you can draw little designs on the edges, and you can cut them out later. And if you want to be extra like me, you can cut out little hearts. But if you want to be really extra like me, you can cut out little dicks. Because dicks. And anyway, we hope you had a wonderful time here at Crotchpot Cooking. This is my banana dick. Dropped off the head. And you know what? It's sad, but I'm gonna still eat it anyway. Tune in next week for Crotchpot Cooking, Channel 69. I can't wait to 69 with you all. No, it's bad. It's bad. Let's go in there. Are you still here?